Hey guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Dark Souls. I was about to say our Dark Souls. I've been spending too much time on the Dark Souls subreddit. Anyway, I've decided that we are going to go to an area known as the Duke's Archives first. So in order to get here, first we're going to go to Northernlion. And then we're going to make our way through the orange sunlight gate that we couldn't get to before. And also, I don't believe I showed you before, because why would I show you it if we couldn't get to it already? Now, I've mentioned a couple times that if you're going to go to the Duke's Archives and thus fight Seath the Scaleless, you are going to want... I might as well rest at this bonfire just in case I die early on. I won't spawn so far away. I do have to fight Seath the Scaleless at the end of this area. Probably not at the end of this video because it's a relatively long area. And it's a good asset to have the Cursebite ring for that. Now, you might remember in New Londo Ruins, that's where the Cursebite is, but I didn't get to it because I kind of lost my way and was like, oh, whatever, I'll get it later. And now I've beaten the area and don't actually have to go back there ever again. Which is great, but also bad because I don't have the Cursebite ring. I've decided, you know, we'll try it without the Cursebite ring. I've never done this before, but this is also the first time I think I've ever had the dingy armor set, which is actually the armor set that you get when Lautrec murders your firekeeper, and you still get to keep it even if she comes back, so I don't know if she's just keeping a second one somewhere. This has pretty high curse resistance on its own, so as long as we're not doing horribly during the fight against Seath, we should be okay. Also a pretty common spot where you can find some summoning help. Although, you know, not necessarily, because that's been kind of a sore spot throughout this Let's Play. I wasn't talking about you, Mark286. Now, this is the way to the Duke's Archives. We are going to have to deal with these boar first. Now remember, we had a couple of these, or we had one of these, in the Undead Parish. I believe this is a more powerful version of the one that we saw there. But still not going to be too much of a problem for us. Every hit that it gets on us will be, like, substantial. But as long as I monitor my stamina, we should be okay. There's a bonfire extremely close to this. So as long as I don't get killed, it doesn't matter if I use all my Estus. Remember, he's got a weak spot there on his tail, obviously, so if we can hit that with a fire orb, or, you know, right on his torso as well, that's fine too. You miss me. This would be a great time to have the Pyromancer spell Combustion, but what can I say, you know? I don't want to level up Attunement anymore because I would rather spend that on, like, Dexterity or Vitality or Endurance. Now, these guys should drop something. There's two of them. If this one doesn't drop something, which it didn't, the other one hopefully will drop the Fang Boar Helm, which is a pretty cool helmet. Not necessarily useful, but cool looking anyway. And when it comes to, like, player versus player or even summoning, it's better to look cool than be functional. You'll see a lot of people online that are all wielding, like, lightning greatswords and wearing Havel's armor, or, sadly, wearing Silver Knight armor. That shit's super lame, man. Except for Silver Knight armor, because it's awesome and it makes you look like a badass. I prefer the guy who's, like, naked and wielding a club and just throws poop at you the whole time. Like those dung pies that we picked up in, Blighttown. Alright, let's throw some great Chaos Fireballs at this guy. Again, there's a bonfire extremely close to us. Oh, God. Probably heal. One more great Chaos Fireball will do it. But I don't want to die right here. That would be embarrassing for me. That would have been probably our death right there. Now he's dead. He did drop the Fang Boar Helm. Cool. Let's put that on because, you know, Silver Knight Helm is cool and all. Fang Boar Helm. Fuck yeah. Guy looks crazy now. I'm not sure if that changes our equipment burdens. Oh, it does, I think. I think that does make us a little bit... That puts us under 50. Would we be under 25 normally? We'd have like 32. Nah, I don't think so. Whatever. We'll just keep this up. Still got fast roll? Damn right we do. This is fine. I can deal with this for the badass factor. So we'll rest at this bonfire. Unfortunately, this bonfire doesn't have a warp associated with it, which is a darn shame. Because it means we'll have to go through that hallway every single time if we die, or if we warp out of here and then die at some point. Although, normally, most people tend to do Duke's Archives all in one shot. Not necessarily in one sitting, but they don't necessarily leave the area before they, you know, move on to do something else. This is probably one of the more common areas to do first after you get the Lord Vessel. Again, recall that if you're not trying to get into the Dark Wraiths, you can do New Londo Ruins whenever you want, essentially. Before the end of the game, of course. You could do it after you do New Londo, or after you do Duke's Archives. You can do it before. You can do it first, second, third, fourth, or fifth. Of course, we had to do it first. Just gonna murder these crystal guys. Heal a little bit. I really should have kindled, reversed hollowing and killed that, kindled that bonfire. What am I even saying right now? So that I had more Estus, but this is okay. I'm just gonna have to be a little bit cautious. And I can always use humanity to heal up. It's not, you know, the best decision. These are essentially just crystal versions of the regular undead that we fight. Not very strong, in particular. Do give us a lot of souls, and occasionally drop crystal weapons, which are really useful. But, of course, as you might expect, have very, very low durability. Now, the cool thing about these archers, and by cool, I mean really aggravating, is their arrows are essentially homing. So if they shoot an arrow, you can move, like, left and right to try to strafe around it. Oh, God, there's so many of them. But it will still probably hit you. Especially if your shield isn't up, as mine was not right there. So that thing on the ground is probably a crystal weapon. They usually hit really hard, but have poor durability. So, like, and they cannot be repaired either, so... it's in a bad position. Let's pick... oh, it's a kite shield. Okay, that's fine, too. Finally, we'll get a chance to murder this archer who's been making our life a living hell. Look at the way that that arrow came out of the bow there. That's what I mean when I say they have homing shots. We'll come across another bonfire fairly quickly, so as long as we can survive with 5 Estus here. Cool. So what do we have in this room? We have a channeler. Total dickbag. We have a couple of crystal soldiers somewhere. Alright, just roll over that soul arrow. These will hit you through your shield, as you can see right there. Wow, did a lot of damage through the shield. Now, hopefully I can kill this channeler. They do have an ability to warp, which is a super pain in the ass. Yep, and he's going to use it right there. Where did he go? Hopefully not somewhere difficult. Oh, there he is. Okay. Let's heal up. Hopefully he can't hit me through the damn bookshelf. And then, what should I do? This is a difficult spot. We've got, what, like 2 archers and a channeler up there, all doing ranged attacks. Some of them will hit me through my shield. First, let's pick up the item that's underneath the staircase here. I lost my bearings for a second. I forget what that item is. It's probably some kind of shard or chunk. Which is fine by me. What is this guy doing? Oh, Soul of a Brave Warrior. That's another common item, obviously. Okay, channeler! Go on the channeler! Murder him. I don't know if he can warp again. Hits so hard. Okay, he's dead. Fantastic. The channelers are by far the worst enemies that you're going to run across in this area. Archers usually die a little bit faster than standard crystal soldiers. 3 hits as opposed to 4. I really should be doing more damage than this. When I did this on my last character, I had a lightning +5 Uchi Katana. Again, probably one of the nerdiest sentences I've ever said in my entire life right there. But that's okay. Just make sure you don't get killed here. I've used a lot of Estus here, but this is probably the most difficult area in the early part of Duke's Archives anyway. Let's heal up to nearly full. Save 1 Estus just in case we, you know, run into a difficult situation. And I'll try to remember where the heck we're going here. This area is a little bit convoluted. But, you know, like most areas in Dark Souls, once you get it the first time, relatively easy to work from there and do it over and over again. So I've done this area 2 or 3 times now in my Dark Souls career. I expect that at least navigation will not be a problem. Beating it, maybe, you never know. Certain things can take you by surprise the more you play. I'm trying to remember how we get to the next bonfire. It's actually, you know, now that I think of it, kind of dumb to think about that because it's a substantial distance away. Not a mimic. You can tell by the chain, right? Twinkling Titanite. Okay, so we can use that to upgrade special weapons and armor. For example, all of our Silver Knight armor requires Twinkling Titanite to upgrade. Not necessarily rare. It used to be rare, I believe, before the game was patched in 1.05. But now it can be purchased for 8,000 souls from the giant blacksmith in Anor Londo. 8,000 souls might seem like a lot, but if you do co-op at that Ornstein and Smough boss fight, you're gonna get 8,000 souls, like, easily. Every successful co-op is worth 25,000 there. On new game, on new game plus, I believe it's worth probably close to 40,000. So you can easily farm souls there, which is what a lot of people do. Or you can just pick it up here. There are enemies in the Crystal Caves, which is the area, you know, just before the Seath boss fight that we'll be dealing with, that drop Twinkling Titanite regularly. Especially if you have a lot of humanity, which of course boosts your item discovery. Or the Covetous Gold Serpent Ring, which also boosts your item discovery. Both very important, even though I don't have the Covetous Gold Serpent Ring. And I always forget. It's in Sen's Fortress, but I never remember the actual area it's in. So usually I just don't get it. I'm not usually too worried about farming. Ah, there we go. Let's get out of here. It looks like he's gonna one-shot us. I don't feel bad about using Pyromancy on these guys. These guys are still fairly difficult enemies. The exception is if you're strong enough to just kill them before they can even get one attack in. Otherwise, oh god! Fuck you! I got extremely lucky to not be killed there. Let's get the heck out of there. Is he gonna run? Please don't tell me he has a running ability. There, okay, he's dead. Oh, man. Crystal Knight Shields. Fantastic. I am gonna use a humanity to heal. It might seem like I'm wasting humanity, but keep in mind that this also contributes to my item discovery, and it's not wasting it unless I actually die. If I stay alive, then it doesn't matter. Like, that humanity just becomes humanity that I can give to Cap. When I give it to him, it puts me one step closer to getting that infinite invasion orb. And I'm not suggesting that I'm going to actually hold on to this 5 humanity. There's probably going to be a time when I'll lose my bloodstain and not be able to pick this up. But if I do, then using that humanity isn't a waste. It's just something that I would have done later anyway. Okay, one second. I gotta figure out what we're doing here. I'm trying not to spoil anything. We're gonna lose Havel's Ring, put on a Rare Ring of Sacrifice. Rare Ring of Sacrifice means you don't lose souls or humanity when you die. Oh, I forgot about this Crystal Soldier. Alright, this guy is not wearing Havel's Ring or the Ring of Favor and Protection because he is slow as molasses. But he hits pretty hard. Like I said, these Crystal Shields have pretty good defense, but no durability. And the Crystal Sword, man, it hurts. People using Crystal Weapons online do extremely well, but they don't do extremely well for long because their weapon just breaks. They do extremely well. There should be a Crystal Lizard in here, and after I get him, there he is. I'll talk about the Crystal Lizards a little bit. Oh, don't warp! Don't warp! Kill him! There we go. Okay. I think I'm gonna be able to get to him. Whew, that was close. We get some Twinkling Titanite. So every now and then in the game, there's guys called Crystal Lizards. And if you murder them, they try to warp out of the way, but if you manage to murder them, you usually get some kind of huge boost in terms of your Titanite. Usually they drop Twinkling or Blue Titanite chunks. Let's traverse the white light. Oh god, it's Seath the Scaleless. Now, this is a boss fight, I hate to spoil it, but it's like in the original... Not the original, it's like in Mega Man X. I'm just gonna try to get myself killed here, actually. That is my curse meter that's building up. So that's why the Curse Bite Ring is important to have here, because even when you fight him for real, he has this curse breath attack that you can see right here. Makes these crystals, and if the crystals hit you, they cause your curse meter to rapidly go up. Although not as rapidly as I would like right now. Please just murder me. This attack should do it. So he still has that attack normally. There we go. I'm gonna die, but because of Rare Ring of Sacrifice, Rare Ring Revival, as opposed to the You Died screen we've seen so commonly, we won't lose any of our souls or humanity, which is fantastic. But yes, he still has that Curse Breath attack normally when you fight him for real, so it's good to have a Curse Bite Ring which quadruples your curse resistance, thus giving you a little bit of more leeway against him. So first we'll have this bonfire here. Yes, I get it, the ring's shattered. I don't even want it anymore. In fact, I have a couple of Rare Rings of Sacrifice. I should probably use... I get it, the ring's shattered. Let me access my menu or something. English is my first language. I can read this sentence very quickly. Oh my god. Please, thank you. Okay, first off, obviously, we'll light the bonfire. We'll reverse hollowing, and the reason for this is, first off, it makes use of that one humanity, which I already used to heal myself. And we'll also kindle, because we might need all 10 Estus flasks for this next part of the game. Pretty difficult, to be honest with you. And we'll, 19,000 souls, not much else to do with that. And again, losing 19,000 souls, psh, it's nothing. We might as well equip another ring as well. Why not Havel's Ring? With Havel's Ring and Ring of Favor of Protection, I could probably wear Havel's Armor. But, that would give me obviously added defense, and it might not incur much in the way of movement cost. But I just like the way Silver Knight Armor makes me look. It looks lean, you know? And you know, a lot of people have been commenting like, you know, as a Dark Souls professional, aficionado, doing the things that you do in this game makes me cringe. Well, kind of the cool thing about Dark Souls is that if you're good enough at the combat and, you know, you're patient, you can pretty much play the game however you want. And that's one of the things I love about the game so much. It's very open-ended with a playstyle. You can play it many different ways. And the way I choose to play it works just fine. What have I died like 6 times over the course of this Let's Play so far? Maybe a few more times. Let's not count that Seath the Scaleless one. Okay, we can't get out here. And I believe when we open this door, we will get kind of a cutscene. Which I don't necessarily want to deal with. Hey, man, Serpent Guard, what's up? Fuck you! One-shotted him, which will give us the key to our own cell. Seems like pretty shoddy defense, if you ask me. So what we will do is open this door. And then we should get a small cutscene. That scares the shit out of me every single time. Alright, so they've unleashed those, like, serpent guardians. I believe their name in the game is Pisakas or Pikazas. Now you'll see that these serpents are like, fuck, what did we do? Apparently that siren makes them angry. It makes me pretty angry too, to be honest with you. So what they're gonna try to do is rush for this door. But I'm gonna say, I don't think so, buddy. And as they come up here, I'm gonna try to murder them. Because it'll make my life a little bit easier on the ground. I am gonna have to murder those serpents. In all honesty, they're not too bad, though they hit really, really hard. See, these guys even aren't even concerned with me, which is really scary the first time you play through, because you're like, fuck, how powerful are these serpents? Because obviously in Sen's Fortress, those man serpents were like hard as hell. At least until you got the lightning spear. Now we're going to just look on the staircase here, because I don't want to be taken by surprise by them. Okay, they're starting to come up, but usually they come up like one or two at a time, which is great because I can just use my Great Chaos Fireball. That is 4 at a time that they are coming as right now. This could kill me, but it doesn't bother me. The bonfire's right here. I laugh in the face of death. Alright, Great Chaos Fireball murdered one. Oh god, they're coming! Roll back! Okay, I didn't need to waste a Great Chaos Fireball there. Is there another serpent? I think I killed 4 of them right there. There's something like 8 or 10 of them. But that was the large group right there, so we should be okay. Don't feel too bad about using my Pyromancy. Normally I suffer like heavily from Too Good to Use syndrome, where I just hold on to good spells until there's like no point. I'm already powerful enough to make them essentially outdated. This is not one situation like that. I like using my Pyromancy a lot because it is, like, pretty substantial burst damage. Does that kill them in one hit? That's fantastic. Hopefully the Fire Orb does the same. Close. Oh my god, why waste another Fire Orb? He's got, like, almost no health left. Sorry, Crystal Soldier. I have basically no intention of letting you out of there. I believe there's some consumable soul items down there. Okay, 4 more. We might actually have to use our attacks to kill some of these guys, which, what year is it? 2011? Just try to aggro a couple of these at a time. Again, dealing with them all in a group is a pain in the ass. Dealing with them one at a time is fine. I'm not sure if these guys have an attack where they can one-shot you. I'm actually not sure I've ever been hit by these guys, because I'm always so nervous about getting hit by them. Pisakas also have some interesting lore, if you're into that sort of thing. Please tell me that hits. Oh, it got one. Okay, at least did damage to him. Gotta be a little bit careful here, because these guys can actually hit me through the railing. And they're all, like, basically dead, but I think they have 350 health, it looks like, and the Fire Orb does 349. I should just shoot them with an arrow or something. Oh, God! That might be Cursed Breath. I was gonna say, I'm just gonna go up and hit this guy normally with my weapon. Then I was like, fuck that. Still 3 of these guys left, which sucks. I wish I had more uses on my spells. I think these guys respawn, though. And there's 2 more in here, but they're kind of passive. Again, as I mentioned, there's some interesting lore about the Pisakas that we'll talk about after I kill them. Please don't hit me with your curse breath. Please come at me. Oh man, I still have one dead. I still have fire bombs, don't I? Let's get rid of our transient curses. We probably won't need those again. One fire bomb. Make it count. I'm not even sure that this will. It might do enough to kill one of the ones that already got hit. But other than that, it might be totally useless. Oh, 102. That's all right. That saves me a hit that I have to do. Okay, now we've only got one left. I can probably safely melee this guy as long as I don't get hit by whatever that breath is. It looks like curse. Curse typically has a blue look to it in this game. Now, the Pisakas. First, we'll talk about Seath the Scaleless a little bit. Seath is a dragon, as you remember from the opening cutscene, but unfortunately he does not have, unfortunately for him anyway, he does not have immortality like all the other dragons have. Sorry, I know you're weeping and stuff, but I'm gonna murder you because you drop awesome healing spells, even though you are pacifist. So he goes kind of insane trying to research immortality. These are obviously good miracles here. I don't even use miracles, but it's nice to have them just in case, you know, maybe once in a blue moon I'll decide to use a miracle at some point during this Let's Play. So he does research into scales, which give the dragons their immortality. But this causes him to go insane, and all of his experiments kind of revolve around maidens. So it seems like, if you read the item descriptions, the Pisakas are maidens, like normal human females, who Seath has experimented on, and they're kind of like the failed experiments of his. Now, I really wish I had some kind of area of effect attack that I could use on these guys, so I'm just kind of circling around extensively here trying to get a backstab. Backstab on that guy will kill him in one shot, but otherwise we're gonna have to be a little bit more cautious. If I could just, again, killing one of them makes the rest of this so easy. Oh, he's not dead yet? Fuck it, I'll take some damage to kill him. 10 Estus. I haven't used a single Estus yet, which is pretty surprising. Come at me. Backstab. This is a backstab. Perfect backstab opportunity. Okay. Murder his friends. Said murder. Thank you. Alright. It's another perfect backstab opportunity. More of a shoulder stab in that situation, but that's okay. Just get one more attack on him. I'm surprised how well this area works out. Normally it's kind of difficult for me. I've never been invaded in the Duke's Archives. But certainly it's not out of the question. It has happened before. To some people, certainly. What are we missing down here? Some items that I can't seem to get to, even though I do have the master key. So we'll turn off the siren here. Again, I play with my sound off, so I haven't noticed how it's been on this entire time. I apologize for that. Hopefully I did something in the audio balance to make sure that it worked okay and you could still hear me over the siren. But if I didn't, then I apologize for myself. Now, we did get the giant door tower key, or whatever it's called. So what I will do is actually go back and rest at this bonfire, and then in the next video we'll make our way through the rest of the Duke's Archives. Possibly the rest of the Duke's Archives. Again, it's a fairly big area. Probably the biggest in the game after the acquisition of the Lord Souls. Or sorry, the Lord Vessel. So just run up here. I always forget how long this run is. Like, New Londo Ruins is pretty big, but you can skip a lot of it once you get the key to the seal, which is exactly what I did. Demon Ruins and Lost Izalith are pretty big as well. Anyway, we'll rest here. As always, thank you guys for watching. I will see you next time.